What's up, everybody? So this is Juniper Parks and Rec, the water park area, and then this is the Olympic swimming pool. They just put the cover up. For the last few times I've worked out there, the cover's been open for the summer because it's been nice and hot, but the cover is in place now and it's a lot warmer. They have a really great heating system. You can see the forced air that goes all the way to the end. So I'm gonna go swim on the deep end side and see if we can get a good workout. So
okay, hey everybody, so I'm just about ready to swim. I got the jammers from Brazil,
some like lost and found goggles from God knows where, but one of the really great things that I've implemented is the earplugs. They really are a game changer. There's different kinds. These are the silicone kind. I had a pair of like the plastic ones that worked a little bit better, frankly. But you know, if your reservation about getting to swim with God is getting water in your ears, then you take those are a real game changer. So I'm gonna start out from what I learned watching Swim 360 with Carl O'Donnell with some swim on the side, so just some kicks on the side. So we'll do that for that.
in the corner, so we're going to do a 500 swing, so we're going to do it between 7 and 18.
So we're starting at 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, I'll go on to 30, 22. Thank you.
This is an Olympic pool, but it's an Olympic pool. So, I don't really want to say that. I've never done an Olympic 50 underwater, but I've done 25 off the back. So, I'll relax a little bit.
Okay. I do not recommend anybody doing that at home. I've done that many times. It's very, very dangerous. I have trained lifeguards watching the pool, so I feel a little bit safe. The technique that I use for doing hypoxic work is to get hypocapnic, so get rid of that CO2. And it's a good thing to train to be able to hold your breath. So stoked that I could still do a 50. It's mostly up here. It's like turning on the far wall. It's just a decision. It's like, I don't know, going the whole way or no. And you can feel your brain grapple with that decision. But when I decide I'm gonna go the whole way, I just go. So that was good. I need to check that off the list. So doing a little bit of a warm down here. I only have until back there. Five more minutes. So see about doing like a couple sprint 50s. So it's 47, 48. I'm gonna do two or three 50s on the minute. So
watching. Another swim workout at the books. I'm gonna go see if I can get in the hot tub and I hear the puppy out of the car go to frisbee for her, and she's not really happy about it. So peace out. Thanks for watching. See you next time.
How's the little puppy doing?
Hi little puppy.
She's pretty good. Good girl. You're being really good. Good girl. You want to go throw the frisbee? I'll show you how she goes after the frisbee. Gotta get her set up on her leash here. Come here, sweetie. Hey. Don't just go running. I gotta get you on your leashies. Sweetheart, hold on. Okay. All right, frisbee time.
Puppies.
Okay, stay. She knows our little area where we go play. She's so excited. Oh. Good girl. Now you gotta let me throw it if we're gonna throw it. She doesn't quite know how to give up the frisbee. Hey! But she knows this little area, so I'm not worried about her. Okay, sit. Sit. Stay. Nope. She's better with the tennis balls that you throw with the thrower, because I take two tennis balls, and then by the time I'm getting close to her, I throw the second one. But okay, stay. Nope. There you go, stay. Good girl. Okay, ready?
Oh, that's a cool one. Look at that.
Oh, she got it. Okay, ready, sweetheart? Ready? Go get it. Come on. Where are you going? Come here. She basically just likes to run. That's what it comes down to. So I gotta let her run every so often, basically twice a day. Or I need to have her sprint like a lot at once. Come on, sweetie, come on. All right, signing off.